carpool lane.
Hold on, hold on.
Don't get your panties in a bunch.
Hold on, hold on.
I think I left my stove on.
Hold on, hold on.
I can't find my shoes.
Hold on, hold on.
I shouldn't have hit the snooze.
Hold on, hold on.
I see angels right here on earth, and they're all in my damn way.
Well, that's woo! Wrong, that's wrong.
I dreamed I was already there.
Wake up. Wake up.
The coffee line was too long.
Hold on, hold on.
I stopped to feed a unicorn.
Come on, come on.
I think I gotta pee.
Hold on, hold on.
Y'all gonna have to excuse me.
Hurry up, hurry up.
Barack Obama text me.
Yeah, right, yeah, right.
It's not my fault.
You're on, you're on.
I guess I'll have to pole vault.
Look out.
Well, here I am.
The show's tomorrow.
Oh, man. I look like a jackass.
Jackass, jackass. Jackass, jackass.
Jackass, jackass. Jackass, jackass, jackass.
Oh, okay, we got it.
Jackass, jackass. Jackass, jackass, you are a jackass, jackass.
Okay, I think that's enough.
Jackass, jackass.
Okay, we got it. I'm a jackass.
Jackass, 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 jackass.
All right, enough for that.
Troubadour, novelist, socialite, philosopher, philanthropist, entrepreneur, raconteur, teamster, and artist, your host, Wanda Sykes.
Thank you, thank you. All right, have a seat, please. Thank y'all so much. Good grief. Thank y'all so much. I love you too. Thank y'all so much, man. Man, y'all, that was too much information right there, that intro. Good Lord. Damn, y'all had more information about me than NSA. So look, I'm so happy to be here. You know, welcome to Harpo, huh? How cool is this? You know, it's so funny. People were asking me, like why are you gonna do this show, Wanda? I'm like, it's at Harpo. Come on. Who's going to turn that down? This is like our Mecca, you know? I'm serious. I was standing outside, and this woman pulled up, and she parked, and she jumped out the car with a newborn baby, and she held it in front of the Harpo sign. She's like, behold, the only thing greater than yourself. It's Harpo, baby. You know what I love about being here in Chicago? Everybody knows how to get to Harpo. Everybody knows where Harpo is. You know, you just get in the cab. Where you going? Harpo. Boom. Right there. I would say everybody knows. I mean, it's like, you know, they don't even have to be from here. They could just arrive in the country. They know. Yeah, man, Harpo is. I don't know what you're saying, but I know you know where you're going. You know where it is. I'm serious. A blind man brought me here today. I'm serious. Everybody knows how to get to Harpo. Phew. And you know, I have a lot of friends who are from Chicago, so they gave me some history. And they said that, you know, that Harpo, it's really on like a historic location. Because at one point, this was where all the prostitutes roamed. Is what I understand. There were a number of hookers around here. I'm like, damn, y'all went from hookers to Harpo. I guess Oprah totally changed the meaning of working girl, huh? But my thing wonder, how did she get all the hookers out of here? Because, you know, it's hard to get rid of a hoe. It really is. You can't shoo hookers. You know, you can be like, get out of here, hookers. You can't shoo them. You can't scat, you know. A hooker be gone. Was Oprah like the Pied Piper of prostitutes or something? She just pulled out her little magic flute and led them all down to the river. Yeah, and also, I get asked a lot, like, why all female comics, Wanda? Why are you doing a show with just female comics? I'm like, I'm a lesbian, dummy. What the hell? Doing shows with a bunch of men. Everything smelling like balls. Come on. Don't it smell good in here? Huh. Oh, see? It smells like fresh, like potpourri. It smells good in here. Well, thank y'all so much for being here. Give yourselves a round of applause. Y'all look beautiful. Y'all look beautiful. And I want y'all to just sit tight. And when we get back, get ready for some laughs, all right? Okay, we'll be right back.
Up next, look at you moving on the 2 and the 4.
Gloria Bigelow lets loose.
There is no one on television like Yanla Van Zandt. Next Saturday, brand new shows.
Everybody's in.
Grammy-nominated R&B singer and reality star, Selena Johnson.
Feel the full devastation of what it's like to be called a by your mama.
Selena is the drama queen.
You failed your babies.
Iyanla is back.
Just remember, you call me.
Iyanla, Fix My Life, all new next Saturday, 9, 8 Central.
I like a clean kitchen.
I don't do any cleaning. I make dirt.
I'm not big enough or strong enough for this.
There should be some way to make it easier. Here's a box, babe. Open it up.
Oh, my goodness.
What is a wet jet?
Some kind of a mopping device. There's a lot of dirt on here. Morty, look at how easy it is.
It's almost like dancing. Dum, dum, da-dum, da-dum, da-dee-da-da-dum. How does this call the Swiffer dance?
One more step.
My little girl, she loves to help out on big jobs. Good thing there's Bounty Selecticize. It's the smaller, powerful sheet that acts like a big sheet. Look, one Selecticize sheet of Bounty is 50% more absorbent than a full-size sheet of the leading ordinary brand.
I got it.
Use less with the small but powerful picker-upper, Bounty Selecticize, and try Bounty Napkins.
The British are coming! Oh, wait.
It's the Italians.
The Italians are coming!
The 5-passenger Fiat 500L. It's a big new world.
This is gonna start a revolution.
Ooh! I love that just washed freshness. But then it goes to your closet to die. So do what I do. Try New Glow Unstoppables in-wash scent boosters. Toss them in before the wash, then pour in Downy infusions for softness. And they fill your closet with scents so fresh, I could just yodel. And they last for 12 weeks. Downy Unstoppables and infusions. Discover a fresher world.
When my friends pulled the t-shirts out of the box, everyone was really...
Are you still sleeping on mattress technology your grandmother did? Then wake up to the latest in 21st century sleep technology during our Sleep Innovation Sale.
Like the Dr. Bruce bed, designed by the sleep doctor, Dr. Michael Bruce, to provide the very latest in support, pressure relief, and temperature regulation. Buy the Dr. Bruce bed today and get a free box spring and 2 years of interest-free financing during our Sleep Innovation Sale.
Sit and sleep will beat anyone's advertised price, or your mattress is free!
Wellness programs are great, but they can leave you feeling unsatisfied. Give in to temptation with Sinfully Delicious. Slimful Chews. They taste like cheating, but one 90-calorie Slimful Chew in a glass of water can help satisfy hunger for hours, so you get the sweet, chewy treat you crave and stay on your program, too. Slimful and a glass of water. Eating less. Never tasted so good.
Drama.
Cut out all that bull-
Is.
You should have been spending more time with him from the beginning.
Served.
I want to see my son.
Help! Got a baby on the way.
Look at your old ass. You still depending on us. Lord, I thank you for this business that's been here so long. It's like my first baby. And I got to let it go.
Welcome to Sweetie Pies is back. Season premiere next Saturday, 10, 9 central. Following Iyanla, Fix My Life.
On Showtime's Fierce Funny Women, and she made me laugh so much, I said, you know what, we've got to have her here on Hilarious. So she would have been on two shows with shitty titles. Let's be Gloria Bigelow.
My comedy is observational and kind of anecdotal. My mother was horrified when I came out as a comic. Horrified, because she Googled me. And she said, you know, if I can Google you, you know other people can Google you too, which is funny because that's how the internet works. When I told my mom that I was doing this show, she acted like Oprah had just got the network yesterday. And she said, did you know that Oprah has all kinds of shows on OWN? I said, I'm aware. I'm aware of that, Mommy. She'll be very pleased that this is happening.
Okay, give it up for Gloria Bigelow.
Wonderful, so good, and so happy to be here. I am originally from the suburbs of Pittsburgh. Woo, good for you. And I grew up in a really white suburb of Pittsburgh. You know, and I grew up my whole life thinking that white people can't dance, you know, which is not true. But when I see a white person that's a really good dancer, I run up to them like, whoa, look at you. Oh, you're such a good dancer. Look at you moving on the two and the four. Woo! That would be like a white person rolling up to me while I'm reading a book, like, woo, look at her, she's reading a book. Do you guys remember when fancy coffee drinks were just for white people? And black people, we would make fun of white people with their lattes. We'd be like, look at white people with their lattes. Ah, all that milk, you know? But now the coffee places have made their way into all the neighborhoods, and they are in the hood. And black folks, we are there. And full effect. And you know what we are getting? Caramel coffee drinks. With extra caramel, right? Just to kill any taste of coffee that could be in a drink, right? Right? I walked up into a coffee place in the hood, and the sister in front of me was like, can I get a caramel coffee drink with extra caramel? And he was like, do you want the syrup or the sauce? She was like, both. Just coat the cup in caramel, right? And then he said, what size? She said, 40 ounce. I said, hold up a minute. Wait a minute. Yeah. And I said, well, I have got to try this, right? And I was like, can I get a caramel coffee drink with extra caramel? I'm with the syrup and the sauce, just coat my cup in caramel, right? And I got it, and I was like, this is a very distinct taste. It tastes just like diabetes. It was just, it was amazing. I am not a fan of rap music because I have ears and self-esteem. And what? Please. I can't. I rolled up into the bank and they were playing rap music in the bank with my money. I don't like that. I turn in line, and I get up to the teller, and I'm like, excuse me, Diamond, why are you playing rap music in the bank? This is not a check-cashing place, right? And she looks at me, and she's like, we cash checks. I said, I know you cash checks. This is a bank. But don't you think you should be playing something maybe like more relaxing, maybe something classical? And she looked at me, she was like, what, this is a classic. This is Biggie off of his Juicy album. You gonna give me all my money. Right now. I have a gay boy, you know, black women and gay men. Sometimes we get together, you know, we get together and we're like, hey, girl. Kiki, that's what we do, right? But I feel like lately he's been trying to like out sister girl me. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I mean? Just taking a sister act a little too far, right? Right? You know, like I called him last week. I was like, hey girl, hey. He was like, girl, child ain't safe in a family of men's. Did you just color purple me? Taking this shit too far, you know? And I called him last week and I was like, hey girl, hey. And he was like, trouble don't last always. I was like, you are a 32-year-old white boy from the Midwest. Why do you sound like a 200-year-old dead slave? This ain't beloved. What's wrong with you? It's ridiculous. You know, and I feel like he's just gonna take it way too far. Like next year I'll call him and I'll be like, hey girl, hey, and he'll be like, did you just click and pop at me? You're taking the shit too far. I've been thinking about this, and I think that we should take the word ghetto out of the popular vernacular, right? You know, because nowadays everything is ghetto. Kids are like, my technology is so ghetto. And I'm like, 3G instead of 4G does not ghetto make. That's not ghetto. And I feel like people don't know how to use the word ghetto in context. I was at a dinner party, and at the end of the night, my friend Becky was like, I'm gonna roll ghetto style. I was like, oh shit, what's she gonna do? Pull out a pack of Newports or a gun? I don't know. She pulls out a Tupperware container and fills it with carrots and crudité. Carrots and crudité. That's not ghetto. Ghetto would be if she named her child crudité, right? You want to use that word in context. Thank you all so much. My name is Gloria Bigelow.
Coming up,
gross.
Andy Smith talks about the joys of childbirth.
Bring on the drugs, bitches.
With my little girl, every food is finger food. So I can't afford to have germy surfaces. But after one day's use, dishcloths can redeposit millions of germs. So ditch your dishcloth and switch to a fresh sheet of new Bounty Duratal. Look, a fresh sheet of Bounty Duratal leaves this surface cleaner than a germy dishcloth, as this black light reveals. It's durable, cloth-like, and it's 3 times cleaner. So ditch your dishcloth and switch to new Bounty Duratal, the durable, cloth-like picker-upper.
It's 7 a.m. and Steve is already thinking about tomorrow, which is why he's investing in his heart health by eating Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Good morning, Dad.
Hi, sweetie.
Here's another eye-opener. Not only is Kellogg's Raisin Bran heart healthy, it's a delicious source of potassium.
Mom, make you eat that?
I happen to like raisins. That's what I'm talking about.
Invest in your heart health with Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
You wait all year for summer. This summer was definitely worth the wait. Summer's best event from Cadillac. Let summer try and pass you by. Lease this all-new Cadillac XTS for around $399 per month or purchase for 0% APR for 60 months. Come in now for the best offers of the model year.
My ideal man is someone with a lot of confidence.
Lovable and creative.
Someone who's smart, articulate.
Because I look for something that can complement me.
And when I'm looking for love, I'm looking for a best friend.
Someone who's positive, adventurous, confident.
With BlackPeopleMeet.com, it gives you everything that you need to find what you're looking for.
It's all right there. You just gotta open your eyes and look for it.
This is where BlackPeopleMeet.com.
Are you feeling buried by all...
Wesselow Nissan and Wesselow Honda have been closed and sold forever. The all-new Ocean Auto Mall is ready and open for your business. But there's only one problem. All remaining Wesselow Nissan and Wesselow Honda inventory must be sold, regardless of profit or loss, with all pre-owned inventory at pennies on the dollar. That's right, pennies on the dollar.
At Charter, we wanted to do something special to say thank you to our customers. So we created Live It with Charter. It's a free rewards program that gives you points every month just for being a Charter customer. Points that you can exchange for all kinds of stuff, from electronics to sporting goods to family vacations, even cash. Don't miss out on getting the thanks you deserve. Sign up today at liveitwithcharter.com.
Next Saturday, brand new shows.
Everybody's in.
Grammy-nominated R&B singer and reality star, Selena Johnson.
You feel the full devastation of what it's like to be called a by your mama.
Selena is the drama queen.
You failed your babies.
Iyanla is back.
Just remember, you call me.
Iyanla, Fix My Life, all new next Saturday, 9, 8 Central.
This next comic's Midwestern wit. And like me, she's a mother, but I have a feeling if I scheduled a play date with her, it would be in a saloon. Let's meet the very funny Andy Smith. Take a look.
I'm originally from Janesville, Wisconsin, and I live in St. Louis now, so I'm kind of as Midwest gets. I had a baby 13 months ago. I had no idea that I was going to be able to love some. I was scared the whole time. I was terrified. But boy, they give you one of those, and all of a sudden you stop drinking, and you want to buy a charm bracelet. I didn't know that I would continue doing stand-up comedy. It seemed pretty far-fetched. And everyone tells you that, too. They'll be like, well, comics have kids. A lot of comedians have kids, and they still do comedy. Yeah, those people are men.
Give it up for Andy Smith.
Oh, Chicago, Chicago, Chicago. I missed you guys. Yeah. My boyfriend and I, we did have a baby together. We had a baby. She's 392 days old. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I know. Yeah. Some people like to measure their child's age in months. I've decided to go with days, kind of like a hostage situation. Like we're trapped in a well or something, you know? I was skeptical, though, I gotta tell you. I'm not gonna lie, I was skeptical, you know? Because motherhood is the only job where if you get it and you suck at it, you can go to prison. You know? That's a lot to put on somebody. And by the way, that's the way you're supposed to say it, too. You're supposed to say, we had a baby. That's how you're supposed to say it. That is bullshit. I had a baby. He smoked pot and tickled himself in the garage for about 10 months. Yeah. Right? I had a baby. And people have all kinds of advice for you, too. Oh, they can't stop giving you advice. You know, this is my favorite one. Are you going to go all natural? Are you going to have all natural? all nat. No! What is this, a Civil War reenactment? No, bring on the drugs, bitches. Absolutely not, you know? I got this hippie friend in San Francisco. She's one of these people who sits around eating like tree bark and tennis shoes and stuff. I don't know what she does. She's super annoying, you know? And she's like, Andy, I'm gonna have an at-home water birth. Okay, first off, gross. What, are you gonna move after that? God. You know, it's a medical procedure. You don't just put an inflatable pool in the living room and have at it. She's like, Andy, don't you want the first time that you meet your child to be free of drugs and chemicals? I was like, no. Think of it this way. The first time you meet your child, would you rather you be sweaty and pissed off in an inflatable pool? Right? Or heavily medicated and in kind of a good mood. Yeah. I didn't even smudge my mascara. I look good in all the pictures and stuff. It was nice. Yeah. We're not married, you know. All my friends are married. Some of them don't even have kids. It's like they got married for no reason. I worry about what kind of world I brought her into. You know, every time you read the news, just horrible, horrible, horrible. I read this in the news the other day. I read that girls with breast implants have a much higher rate of suicide. Yeah, I don't have a joke for that yet. That's just really good news. You know, finally, something optimistic, you know. Well, I worry about that. Like having a daughter, you worry about that message that's out there, that's all a woman has to do is just, that's their whole goal in life, just get super hot. That's it. Just get super hot. You don't have to have a skill or a thought in your head. Just toss it up and wait for the checks to start rolling in. Right? Do you know that girls are getting boob jobs for graduation? Yeah, they're getting boob jobs for graduation. Shouldn't that be what you get if you don't graduate? Right? Oh, I heard you failed math. Here's a couple of D's. Go follow your dreams. Yeah. Babies will change your relationship, though. They will. My boyfriend wants to start having sex again. I don't care if I never have sex again. I'm telling you that. I do not care. He's like, we got to start doing it again. And I'm like, oh, stop. You're turning me on. Stupid. You're stupid. I tried to explain it to him, too. Once you have a baby, the thrill of the gamble is gone. Right? The jig is up. The way I see it, I'd been playing Russian roulette for like 20 years, and on April 30th, 2012, I got shot. It did. You know? Yeah. He wants to watch porn. That's his big plan. Oh, that's perfect. Okay. Good thinking, stupid. We were watching one the other night, and the girl takes off her clothes, and she's got a nicotine patch on. What? Of all the things you're currently doing, that's what you've decided to quit? You guys were very nice. Thanks.
When we come back, Brooke Shields drops by and reminds us that she went to an Ivy League school.
Je connais les gens, mais il faut que je pratique parce que... Oh.
Basically, she said yes.
Coming Sunday, July 28th, one of O's guiltiest pleasures is back.
We have a brand new season, and this time around, even a little spicier, let me tell you.
Jam-packed with some of the biggest newsmakers of all time, revealing exclusives.
It's a little strange in a way. There's this little version of Anna running around the house.
What they didn't want you to know.
That was one of the hardest things for me to accept.
I cannot believe that I would do that to my family for money.
Where Are They Now? Season premiere Sunday, July 28th, 10, 9 Central.
At Janae Boyle tweeted, I hate my car with a passion, hashtag untrustworthy. Sad tweet, Janae. But stop by the Honda Summer Clearance event and we'll give you some tweeternatives, like, love my new Accord, hashtag great deal, or standard features for days, hashtag Bluetooth, hashtag rearview cam, or hashtag cute dealer. Who put that in there?
Get a great deal from America's most trusted brand at the Honda Summer Clearance event, happening now.
At a moment like this, I'm glad I used Tampax Pearl.
Tampax Pearl protects better. Only Tampax has a leak guard braid to help stop leaks before they happen. Tampax Pearl protects better.
You guys got plans for the night?
Head out to the city, catch some fireworks.
Why don't you take the train out there? That way you can not have to worry about anything.
Next stop, Fruitvale Station.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Go. I'm scared.
Maybe I'm gonna be fine.
Fruitvale Station, rated R, Friday.
In your busy day, the last thing you need is white marks. Secret Outlast Clear Gel goes on clear with 48-hour odor protection to outlast your day, any day. Secret Outlast Clear Gel.
Sure, it's good if your dog's food is natural, but are the ingredients out of proportion? Like too much protein, too much salt, or too little vitamins? Introducing New Hill's Ideal Balance, created by Hill's Pet Nutritionists with chicken first. It has the right natural ingredients guaranteed to be perfectly balanced. With no corn, wheat, or soy, every ingredient adds to your pet's best health. New Hill's Ideal Balance, 100% balanced nutrition guaranteed.
Holy great look. I don't even...
Hey, buddy.
Oh, hey, Flo.
You want to see something cool? Snapshot from Progressive.
My insurance company told me not to talk to people like you.
You always do what they tell you?
No.
Try it and see what your good driving can save you. You don't even have to switch, unless you're scared.
I'm not scared. It's... You know, we can still see you.
No, you can't.
Pretty sure we can.
Try Snapshot today. No pressure.
There is no one on television like Yanla Van Zandt. Next Saturday, brand new shows.
Everybody's in.
Grammy-nominated R&B singer and reality star, Selena Johnson.
Feel the full devastation of what it's like to be called a by your mama.
Selena is the drama queen.
You failed your babies.
Iyanla is back.
Just remember, you call me.
Iyanla Fix My Life, all new next Saturday, 9, 8 Central.
All right, welcome back, welcome back. Now, before I bring out our last comic, I thought it'd be fun to do something that Carol Burnett used to do on her show. I'm a big fan of Carol Burnett. So can we take some questions from the audience? Want to do that? Let's take some questions from the audience. Sally Jo, can you bring the lights up a little bit so we can see these beautiful people? Oh, hi. How y'all doing? Hey. All right. So who has a question? Anybody?
I got a question. Do you hang out with a lot of celebrities?
Do I hang out with a lot of celebrities? Only in rehab. That's it. No, actually, a lot of my friends like writers and everything, but I do have some friends who are celebrities, and actually, she didn't want me to say anything, but one of them flew in to be supportive today, and Brooke Shields is sitting right over there. Actually, let's go over and say hi to Brooke. Hi, Brooke.
Mwah. You're doing so well. I'm so happy for you.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for coming out here and supporting me. I appreciate it.
Oh, I love you too.
Thank you. Hey, you know what? Why don't you come up there on stage with me? Come on.
No, I'm not joking. You didn't tell me.
Come on. No, I don't need that. Watch. Oh, come on, come on. Just do it. Just for me. For me, please. Come on. Come on. Everyone, come on. Come on. We'll do the questions. Come on. You could, in case I get stumped, you can help answer a question or something for me. Oh, yeah, I mean, yeah, you can do that too. I mean, okay, I know, Brooke, you're tall. Okay, all right, we good. I'm short. I got it. Okay, all right. I'm Mike. Can you just say this?
Okay. All right. Is there another question? Anyone? No. Okay, right here.
So my question is for Brooke. A couple of years ago, you delivered your commencement speech at Princeton, your alma mater. How was that?
Oh, well, it was wonderful. It was great. Thank you. I was very excited. It was a little weird because, most of the people that were in the audience said they weren't even born when I was an undergraduate. I had no idea if they knew any of the references or anything, but it was a privilege, and I was really glad to do it. So.
All right. Cool. Ooh, Princeton. Oh, yeah, nice.
Honors. I got honors.
Oh, honors. Oh, good. Honors. Okay. Okay. Brooke Shields is smart. Okay. Another question. Anyone? Right here.
Hi, Brooke.
Hi. Oh. Hi.
I read somewhere that you are fluent in French. Is that true?
Oui, oui, c'est vrai. C'est une belle langue. Je l'ai étudiée à l'université. Pratiquer, l'utiliser toujours le temps, mais pas seulement pour communiquer, mais en même temps pour c'est pour impressionner les gens. Mais il faut que je pratique parce que. Oh.
Basically, she said yes.
Oh, and you know what I said? She totally speaks French. I don't know if you know this. But she knows how to speak French, yes. Nous devrions sortir pour prendre un verre après le spectacle. Oui, je connais un bar, la proximité. Oh, merci, merci. Ah.
It's still my show.
I don't know how long I have to.
What the hell?
I need some help. I thought maybe that somebody else wanted to ask a question, maybe for you.
Oh, for me? Yeah. I don't need your charity, Brooke Shields.
I know. I'm just saying maybe somebody else wants to ask.
Oh, well, you have a question for me?
I have one.
Yeah.
Okay.
See?
Stand down, Brooke Shields.
How tall are you?
How tall am I? I am 5'2".
I bet you wish you were as tall as Brooke Shields, right?
Y'all know what? I'm so happy my friend came by, but she has to take off now because, she's got a big gig coming up. She's directing Chicago at the Hollywood Bowl, huh? Yeah, so she's got to get out of here.
I'm sorry. That's like, you can't put that much. I didn't want to talk about that.
Oh, you don't want to talk about it?
Why? No, I can't.
Why not?
Because I'm really nervous about it. I have no idea if I'm going to be able to pull it off, if I'm going to have that sort of, you know, feeling of authority and gravitas. I just...
Oh, come on, Bill. You're going to be fine.
I'm not done, okay? I mean, when you're directing actually for the stage, it is extremely important. And it has to be perfect. You can't mess up. You've got to take it seriously. I mean, okay, take your light, right? Uh-huh. Right now, I think it's a little hot. I think you look a little hot, okay? Well, Sally Jo, could you bring her light down just a little bit, please? A little bit more? See? Huh? See?
Bookshelves, you can barely see me.
Oh, no, but it's so dramatic. It's sexy. It's great. Yeah.
But we're doing comedy, Brooke Shields.
Okay, stop complaining and arguing with me. I know what I'm doing.
Brooke Shields done lost her damn mind. they did. Can somebody help me out here? Thank you. Damn. All right. Brooke Shields thinks she's in Chicago now, directing Chicago, huh? So, look, I'm going to see if I can regain control of my show and maybe get some lights back up on in here.
Wanda!
Wanda, do me a favor and cheat to one. Cheat
okay,
to one.
Shield.
Hold the light up a little bit, but cheat to one. Okay, toss it to commercial. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
We'll be right back with more hilarious with Brooke Shields.
Coming up,
sir, I don't have no extra kidney.
Dominique shows her generous side.
If I had three, I might give you one.
Sometimes I think my family off the field is sweatier and messier than my family on the field. So like the NFL, I use Tide, because I'm the equipment manager in this house. That's my Tide. What's yours?
Imagine a match made in skin heaven with Venus and Olay. Olay moisture bars help lock in moisture for less dryness, while 5 blades get Venus close, revealing smooth and goddess skin begins. Only from Venus and Olay.
There's so much I like about this Buick LaCrosse. Sophisticated styling, fresh technology, and an EPA estimated 36 mpg highway.
Like my mom said the day I was born, wow, that's a lot more than I expected. If you don't know the luxurious yet fuel-efficient LaCrosse, you don't know Buick.
Current non-GM lessees lease this Buick LaCrosse with 2 years of scheduled maintenance for around $239 per month. Consider it a new lease on luxury.
Be fearless. Volume without fear of clumps. CoverGirl Clump Crusher. Big green brush curved to crush. 200% more volume, zero clumps. Clump Crusher from Easy Breezy Beautiful CoverGirl.
Not all toothbrushes are the same. Oral-B Pro Health toothbrushes have crisscross bristles that remove up to 90% of hard-to-reach plaque. Feel the difference. Oral-B. Trust the brand more dentists and hygienists use. Oral-B.
We all deserve a good night's sleep. Thankfully, there's ZzzQuil. It's not for colds. It's not for pain. It's just for sleep. Because sleep is a beautiful thing. ZzzQuil, the non-habit-forming sleep aid from the makers of NyQuil.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Did you know the condition?
Are you one of the millions of people living with bladder control problems and on Medicaid? Then stay tuned for a free offer from Active Style.
Hello. At Active Style, we understand your needs and offer convenient, discreet home delivery of a variety of incontinence products. And they may be available at no cost to you if you're Medicaid eligible. When you call us, a personal incontinence consultant, someone like me, will help you find the right product that is both comfortable and makes you feel secure. If the fit is not right, we'll send different products until you are completely satisfied. That's our Get It Right guarantee. Your privacy is assured. Our incontinence products arrive direct to your door in discreet boxes, so no more embarrassing trips to the store. If you or someone you know is incontinent, call us now. And if you're Medicaid eligible, we'll send you a free sample.
If you're on Medicaid, call for your free sample. Active Style is the most convenient and discreet way to get your incontinence supplies.
Call 1-866-482-1490.
Tweetable moment!
Daddyless Daughters, Part 2, with Inyanla Van Zandt. For every woman ready to move beyond the pain.
For the first time in my life, I said, I'm worthy.
Forgive yourself.
The three things you need to know right now.
I don't feel that I can get past it.
Tweet along and let the healing continue.
Oprah's Life Class, Sunday, 9, 8 Central.
Coming next Saturday.
This is not my first rodeo.
Mama Drama.
Cut out all that bull and get to work.
Is.
You should have been spending more time with him from the beginning.
Served.
I want to see my son.
No! Got a baby on the way.
Look at your old ass. You still depending on us. Lord, I thank you for this business that's been here so long. It's like my first baby, and I got to let it go.
Welcome to Sweetie Pies is back. Season premiere next Saturday, 10, 9 Central. Following Iyanla, Fix My Life.
All right, we're back. Yes. Brooke Shields has left the building. Actually, she was escorted out. So now let's get back to the show. In peace. Okay, this woman sounds like she's from generations of funny. I bet her ancestors even cracked jokes while they were being chased by a T-Rex. Let's check out Dominique, ladies and gentlemen.
Growing up, I was always funny, but I would have never thought that I would have been a comedian. That's how I would have made my living. I would have never thought that. I thought I was a singer, but I can't hold a tune to save my life. But I will sing. I will sing like I'm telling you, like I'm Gladys Knight or somebody like that. Sound horrible. Just not my gift, but I can tell a pretty funny joke. Before I did stand up, I worked at an OBGYN. I also worked at the post office. So you probably didn't get a lot of your mail.
Put your hands together for Dominique.
What's going on, Chi-Town? I see y'all in here. Y'all looking good. I'm from D.C. Side of, you know, all right, D.C. in the house. I'm from the blackest side of D.C. too. Southeast D.C. You know, so I didn't grow up with a lot of white friends. But, you know, I live in L.A. now. So I got white friends. I got Ethan and Seth, Jeremy and Molly. You know, it's different. I'm going over their house for barbecues, learning how to eat asparagus. Learning how to eat Brussels sprouts. I said, Jeremy, we don't eat the baby cabbage, we eat the big cabbage. And chop it up and put it in the pan. I said, and we don't eat peas in the potato salad either. I said, I ain't never seen that before. I said, bad potato salad will ruin our whole barbecue. When your auntie walk past there and see them peas, she gonna say, why the hell would Pearl put peas in the potato salad? She didn't ruin my whole damn meal. Why would she do that? I don't need that Rachel Ray shit. Why would she put that in my potato salad? Take it off the table. Take that off the table. Give me my drink and ruin my meal. Having white friends is good for me. But when they start getting high, I go home. I don't mess around with that methamphetamine. I said, Jeremy, I ain't in that much pain. A little weed take my demons away. I said, you need an intervention. He said, well, why you going home? I said, because I'm the only black person in here. So when y'all get to hallucinate and get all high up, I'ma be the joke. I said, I watch too much crime TV for that. You'll never chop my head off and hide it behind the grocery store some damn way. I said, I seen this episode last night. You never had me on Nancy Grace. I say, hell no. Yeah. I said, I know when to do my best Kenny Rogers. I know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away. I'm running out of here. Yeah, but you know, it's good. I mean, having white friends is good for me, you know, because we have a lot of different debates and discussions, like even during the election. We had this big debate about who they were gonna vote for. So they felt like they were gonna vote for Mitt Romney. So I asked them why. I said, y'all rich? They said, no. I said, okay, if you white and you ain't rich, you honey boo boo in them. I said, I don't know what you thought, but that's what he think. I said, honey boo boo can't form a complete sentence. But when they asked her if she could vote, who would she vote for? She stood there and she said, Waka Walla! I said, I know damn well you are. Eat mayonnaise for a snack, you're gonna need health care. And watch out for social media too, you know what I mean? Watch out for that. Social media is crazy. Facebook and all that, it's for fun, but it's crazy. I knew it was bad when my biological father found me on Facebook. I ain't talked to this man in almost 40 years. And he sent me a friend request. I said, that's a damn shame. You know what I mean? And I wasn't gonna be his friend, but my mother said, befriend him, he owed me money. I said, okay, Mom. You know, and I didn't miss him. You know, I didn't miss him because I had a stepfather, you know. that raised me. And I don't even like to call him a stepfather, because that's my father. He had me my whole life, you know? So this particular dude, I didn't miss him. But you know, I got to listen to my mama, so I accept it. I know, but he ain't had no money. You know, but I called him, you know. He said, how you doing? I said, I'm all right. He said, well, what you been up to? I said, for the last 40 years? I said, I got to write a book to say all that shit. I said, I'm okay. I said, well, how you doing? He said, well, you know, I'm hanging in there. I said, okay. He said, I'm sick, you know. I said, all right. I said, well, what's wrong with you? He said, well, you know, I need a kidney transplant. I said, okay, so what you gonna do? You know, because I'm not putting two and two together. I said, so what you gonna do? He said, that's why I'm calling all my kids. I said, oh, no. I said, sir, I don't have no extra kidney. I said, I ain't got but two. If I had three, I might give you one. I said, you throwing me off. You ain't offering to take me to lunch or nothing. You gonna ask for a kidney on the first conversation? I said, that's rude as hell. He said, I said, well, why your kidneys bad? He said, well, you know I'm an alcoholic. I said, sir, I don't know anything about you. I said, but why would I give you my healthy kidney so you can drink my kidney under the table? And I gotta drink water and run marathons for the rest of my life. I said, that don't make no sense. Well, I don't know what to do. I said, well, you're gonna have to pray and ask the Lord to let his will be done. And if you make it, there it is. If you don't, there it is. Because I ain't giving you a damn thing. You know? So he kept talking and talking. He said, well, think about it. I said, sir, the answer is no. I said, you're going to press me now, huh? I said, okay, well, I got to go. He said, okay, when you going to call me back? I said, in about 40 years. So I hung up and I called my father, you know. I said, Dad, I talked to him. He said, what'd he say? I said, he asked for a kidney. My father said, God damn. He said, well, what did you say? I said, I hung up and I blocked his ass. Reported him as spam. Get him off my page. He died about 2 months later. Oh, y'all sad for him? I might have been a match, but we'll never know. Look at all the men looking all serious now. You gotta take care of your kids in case you need a kidney. I'm Dominique. God bless you. You all were excellent.
Thank you so much. One more time for Dominique. Stay with us. We'll be back.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Coming next Saturday.
This is not my first rodeo.
Mama Drama.
Cut out all that bull.
Is.
You should have been spending more time with him from the beginning.
Served.
I want to see my son.
No! Got a baby on the way?
Look at your old ass. You still depending on us.
Lord, I thank you for this business that's been here so long. It's like my first baby, and I got to let it go.
Welcome to Sweetie Pies is back. Season premiere next Saturday, 10, 9 central. Following Iyanla, Fix My Life.
Harvey's I'm So Happy You're Home dance? That's real love. And so was giving him real tasty food. But some leading dog foods add sugar, dyes, or even artificial preservatives. But now there's new So Good from Iams. With 100% real wholesome ingredients and none of those other things. Now that's real love. So is that. New So Good. See what's really in your dog's bowl at Iams.com.
Stress sweat smells the worst, and Secret Clinical Strength gives you 4 times the protection against it. Secret Clinical Strength.
The Chevy Malibu offers an impressive EPA-estimated 34 mpg highway. And during Chevy's model year-end event, you're getting a great deal on the remaining 2013 models. But they're going fast.
What are you doing?
Moving in, before someone else does.
Oh, great.
The Chevy model year-end event.
The 13s are going fast. Time to get yours. Right now, get this great lease on a 2013 Chevy Malibu LS for around $169 a month.
Our daughter is all Kate. They have the same walk, same grin, and the same beautiful hair.
With Nice and Easy, get the most natural shade of you. In one step, Color Blend Formula gives expert highlights and lowlights for color so true to you, they may think you were born with it.
She's a mini Kate. I'm a lucky guy.
With the expert highlights and lowlights of Nice and Easy, get the most natural shade of you.
To help save wildlife affected by oil spills, rescue workers have opened up a lot of Dawn. They rely on it because it's tough on grease, yet gentle. But even they'll tell you, Dawn helps open something even bigger. This year, Dawn is also donating $1 million to rescue efforts. Go to DawnSavesWildlife.com. Find out how the little things you do can make a big difference.
You won't believe your eyes. With Olay Regenerist Eye and Lash Duo, the serum instantly thickens and defines lashes. The cream smooths and softens the look of lines. So wow, another eye-opener from Olay.
Captain!
Tuesday, the moment everyone has been waiting for.
I have something to tell you.
Will Candace come clean?
Something is wrong with you if you think I'm weak and helpless.
And just how dirty will she get?
If you go down this road, I will hunt you down.
The mistress.
I'm the one who says when it's over.
The wife.
I need your help.
The showdown.
Be careful crossing the tracks. There might be a train coming.
Tyler Perry's The Haves and the Have-Nots. All new Tuesday, 9, 8 Central.
Only on OWN.
You guys, I'm really worried about Wanda.
I know, she's acting a little strange, right?
A little. That chick done lost her mind.
I think it's being here at OWN. With Oprah gone, she's walking around like she's the new queen of Chicago.
Maybe we should say something.
I ain't saying nothing. Them people put me in a nice hotel, free liquor in the green room. I don't care if that little lady goes Amanda Bynes.
I still think we should say something. But I like Wanda. I don't want to see her go off the rails, crash and burn, right? Unless I can tweet it.
You want to say something about it? Now's your chance.
Shug, silly, squeak.
Wanda, I'm sorry. Miss Sophia?
Yes?
Are you okay? We're worried about you.
I'm not.
I'm fine. Why do you ask?
You won't let us call you by your real name, and you're dressed like Mrs. Butterworth.
Yeah, and you look like you need one of them hug yourself jackets.
Okay. Miss Sophia's gonna tell y'all the truth. I lost a bet with Miss Oprah, and she made me dress like this and pretend to be this fictional character for a week.
That's awful.
Terrible.
Indeed.
That shit is hilarious.
You think this is bad, you should see what she made Kim Whitley do.
Don't eat.
Tonight's comedians, Gloria Bigelow, Andy Smith, Dominique, and our special guest for the evening, the one and the only Brooke Shields. All right, that's our show for the evening. Thanks for watching, and good night.
Flat.
I can try, boo. I felt that I needed to get the tire someplace away from the city and the traffic and see what had caused this flat. I mean, deep down. So I had the tire brought out to my retreat. So, do you know why you are flat? I mean, the real reason why you are flat. The surface is not your problem. It's the inner tube. that we must deal with. I wanted your family to be here as well. It's your big sister I'm interested in at the moment. Miss Taya, you've got a weight problem. You need to let some air out. Don't you hiss at me. Tread lightly, boo. Tread lightly. Well, I just got some information from my producer. Are you high right now? It was hard gauging that tire. But finally, I felt like I had a breakthrough. If you stay flat, what will happen?
I won't roll.
Yes! You won't roll! You won't roll! Ha ha! Hallelujah! Yes! Okay, everybody to me. We need some hugs. Did some good work. Did some good work. I know you're not ready. You're not ready. It's okay, beloved. Yeah.
Where the hell is my tire?
I'm so glad y'all are here, and I really hope Iyanla has a sense of humor. I'm serious, because that would be awful. I don't want to get my ass whipped while somebody's calling me beloved and boo. Do you know why I'm whipping your ass, boo? But I'm sure she has a sense of humor, because, you know, anybody who can sit down and try to rationalize with DMX, You got to be able to laugh at yourself. Y'all see that shit? That was some crazy shit. Right? I mean, even Iyanla was like, oh, boy. I bit off a little bit more than I can chew. It was so bad, I was sitting there going, you know what? I need some weed. Jesus. I don't even smoke weed anymore. But anyway, don't worry, because there will be no drama on this show. It's all about comedy tonight. Yes, it's all about some comedy. And we have some very funny women coming to the stage tonight. And you know what cracks me up is that I keep getting asked, Wanda, you know, why are you doing a show with all female comics? I'm like, because Oprah asked me to. Shoot, Oprah asked you to do something, you move. You know what I'm saying? Shoot, she could have asked me to do a show with all golden retrievers. I'm telling you, I'd have been up here with some of the funniest golden retrievers you've ever seen. I've been up here with some sausages and bacon in my pants, and dog biscuits. Oh, good joke, Shadow. Good boy, good boy. Heel, fetch. I'm telling you, man. But I'm saying, really happy to be here. And y'all look great. Give yourselves applause, round of applause. Everybody looking sharp, smelling good. So I want y'all to just relax, and we'll be right back, all right? Okay.
When we return, Marina Franklin loves being a cougar. And later, a magical performance from Kim Whitley.
Now you see it, now you don't. coming next Saturday.
What's my name?
Miss Robbie is back.
I'm a third degree black belt in cooking. Bam!
In a delicious new season of Sweetie Pies.
Why are you so cheap? Show me the money.
Welcome to Sweetie Pies returns next Saturday, 10, 9 central.
Sassoon experts would never settle for smooth that just flies away. With the Vidal Sassoon Smooth Collection, now sleek meets chic. Extreme smooth combing cream defies frizz and flyaways for up to 24 hours. Vidal Sassoon Smooth. Salon genius. Affordable for all.
This is so, so soft.
Hey, hon, remember, you only need a few sheets.
Ooh.
Charmin Ultra Soft is made with extra cushions that are soft and more absorbent. Plus, you can use four times less.
Charmin Ultra Soft.
You won't believe your eyes. With Olay Regenerist Eye and Lash Duo, the serum instantly thickens and defines lashes. The cream smooths and softens the look of lines. So wow, another eye opener from Olay.
What if we took all this produce from Walmart and secretly served it up in the heart of Peach Country? It's a fresh over. We want you to eat some peaches and tell us what you think.
They're really juicy.
It must have just come from the farm.
This right here is ideal for me.
Walmart works directly with growers to get you the best quality produce they've ever had.
What would you do if I told you all this produce is from Walmart?
Wow!
Is it really?
Find fresh peaches and all your quality produce backed by our 100% money-back guarantee. Walmart.
When it comes to your smile, the coffee you drink adds up over the years, causing deep, set-in stains. Crest 3D White Strips go beyond where most toothpastes can reach, safely removing stains below the enamel surface to whiten as well as a $500 treatment. Crest 3D White Strips.
Dear grown-ups, We've heard Netflix has something really cool.
Oh, yeah.
A place packed with all our favorite TV shows and films. It's Netflix Kids.
Hey!
Help your little ones discover the best kids' TV shows and movies. Enjoy instant fun.
Cool.
For the whole family. On your computer, TV, game console, tablet, or mobile.
Awesome!
Netflix Kids. Included free with your $8 a month subscription. Start your free trial today.
I am a non-attorney spokesperson. Did you know the condition?
Life is full of compromises. But when it comes to what your family really loves, you shouldn't have to sacrifice. And that goes double for ice cream. Now you don't have to give up. You can give in with Dreyer's slow-churned light ice cream. We churn it slowly for all the rich and creamy taste with just half the fat. Dreyer's slow-churned light ice cream. Nestle, good food, good life.
It's the end of the model year, and Nissan is giving you a direct line to the people, places, and music you love. An easier way in. And more ways to see. And now, only Nissan can give you the bottom line on all of it. Save up to $5,300 on Rogue. Or get a $259 per month lease on Pathfinder. Your choice has never been easier. Shop at your local Nissan store or choose Nissan.com today.
Bill Cummings. There is not one raised toilet seat in this building. All right. Her serial dating is what fuels this Chicago native's comic misadventures. All right. Let's meet Marina Franklin.
I had a guy once approach me on the street and say, hey, you're that girl who has problems with relationships. I talk about every guy that I've ever dated. They're not safe when they date me. I put their business out there on the street. If they've lost a fight and I've seen it, it's going on stage. If they didn't have a job, it's going on stage. If they were just a loser, it's going on stage.
Let's hear it for Chicago's own Marina Franklin.
Thank you, Chicago. Yes. Oh, it's great to be home. Yeah. I am originally from Chicago, and I love this. This is also the home of Barack Obama, right? Our Lord and Savior. I love him. I also love Michelle Obama. Yeah, you have to. I think she's just so classy and just such a lady. Like, I was actually thinking this She's from Chicago. I'm from Chicago. I could have been a first lady. But they would have done that background check. And I ain't no lady. So my name is Marina, which is, by the way, it's not a great African name. I did not get one. I apologize. My sister got the African name. Her name's Naila, which means one who succeeds. Marina, that's me. Means a place where you dock boats. And you can take that any way you want to. I live in Harlem, New York now. That's where I live, which is actually changing, you know. Like, there are white people in Harlem now. It's gentrified, you know. You could tell there are white people in Harlem. There are signs. Like, we got, like, 3 Starbucks, salad. White people bring salad. That's great. Like, the first time I saw a ripe tomato, I was like, ooh, they coming. That is a nice tomato right there. So I just got out of a relationship. That's obvious. He was very young. He was the youngest guy I ever dated. He was 11 years younger than me. He was young and white, so not a cougar, Black Panther. Oh, yeah. I was a real predator. Now, this was the whitest guy I ever dated. Like, he just, you know, never been around Black people. And by the way, I don't just date white guys. It's just the economy was bad, so, you know. What? It's like a storm is coming. I need my white guy. But this is the whitest guy I ever dated. Just never been around Black people his whole life, you know? And I'm learning that some white people can do that, just not be around us. Black people, we can't do that. You guys are always in our lives. You know, just showing up. Like, hey, what's going on? Meeting his mom, now that was a situation. Because he had to tell her ahead of time that I was older, 11 years, Black. That's a lot. I couldn't wait to meet her. Because when I met her, I told her, I got your baby boy. You know what? I was thinking about having children with him. But then I also see some of the mothers that have kids and they look like they have lost their minds. So it makes your clock tick and stop. This is gonna be a child I was, that she was yelling at. And she was just like, get your ass over here. I said, get it over here. Now what the hell you crying for? Stop calling me mom. That's confusing. I looked at her. I was like, oh, my God. I was like, you don't talk to a child like that. She looked at me. She was like, what the hell you looking at, huh? You won't raise my child? No. You're doing a great job. I was scared. I ran 3 long blocks. I don't even like running. I was like, don't look back, just keep going. But you can't help it. You want to see what's going on. I looked back for just a second. She was still standing there looking at me.
next up.
Please laugh at my jokes. I have a heart murmur.
Carmen Lynch's farewell performance.
Coming next Saturday.
What's my name?
Miss Robbie is back.
I'm a third degree black belt in cooking. Bam!
In a delicious new season of Sweetie Pies.
Why are you so cheap? Show me the money.
Welcome to Sweetie Pies returns next Saturday, 10, 9 central.
I'm Cecil Gaines. I'm the new butler.
I want to hear all the stories.
The White House swore him to some kind of secret code.
He served seven presidents.
I'm thrilled to be working with all of you over the next 4 years.
And during a time of change...
Something special is going on down here, Dad.
Our boy's in jail, Cecil.
He became their inspiration.
I know your son is a freedom rider.
Turn the bus!
No, I never understood what you all really went through. You've changed my heart.
The Butler, everywhere August 16th.
You know, throughout history, folks have suffered from frequent heartburn. But getting heartburn and then treat day after day is a thing of the past. Block the acid with Prilosec OTC. And don't get heartburn in the first place.
One pill each morning, 24 hours, zero heartburn.
The British are coming! No, wait. It's the Italians. The Italians are coming!
The five-passenger Fiat 500L. It's a big new world.
This is going to start a revolution.
This is a nice boat, Marilyn. You're pretty rich.
Yes, I am.
But not as rich as me.
Oh, I don't know. I'm pretty rich.
Well, I have delectable red velvet cake-flavored ice cream, swirled with cream cheese frosting-flavored ice cream, and sumptuous red velvet cake pieces.
That's a lot of riches.
I love being rich.
Me too.
Introducing Blue Bunny Red Velvet Ice Cream, one of several flavors inspired by Chef Duff Goldman.
Rich. A hot, smelly car versus a Febreze car vent clip. Which comes out on top?
It's just nice.
That's what I was thinking. That's exactly fresh. What I was thinking. Yeah, fresh. Like I could wrap myself in it.
Odors are no match for Febreze. Breathe happy.
Introducing Athenex Body Sculpting Institute. Athenex Microbody Contouring is a new, less invasive way to transform your body by gently removing unwanted fat from stubborn areas, using it to naturally enhance others. It all happens in a single visit without the downtime and risk of major surgery.
My experience was great, and the procedure was virtually painless.
I wanted to do it for myself.
Transform your body into a personal work of art. Call 1-888-71-SCULPT or visit athenexbody.com to learn more.
Can you pass the salt? Thanks. What?
Well, I just signed us up for the Liver with Charter Rewards program, and you know how Charter says thanks. With free reward points every month that can be exchanged for prizes like 3D TV systems, tablets, game systems, vacations, even cash. That's how you say thanks. Pepper?
Get the thanks you deserve. Sign up for the free rewards program at liveitwithcharter.com.
One has been waiting for.
I have something to tell you.
Will Candace come clean?
Something is wrong with you if you think I'm weak and helpless.
And just how dirty will she get?
If you go down this road, I will hunt you down.
The mistress.
I'm the one who says when it's over.
The wife.
I need your help.
The showdown.
Be careful crossing the tracks. There might be a train coming.
Tyler Perry's The Haves and the Have-Nots. All new Tuesday, 9, 8 central.
Only on OWN.
All right, welcome back. The next comedian made her debut on The Late Show with David Letterman. Born in Spain, she's fluent in two languages, Spanish and sarcasm. Let's meet Carmen Lynch.
If I had to describe my comedy, I guess deadpan would be the best word. I actually been performing in Spanish, so it's been kind of fun to go to Spain. I'm more animated in Spanish. Hola, ¿cómo estáis? Vamos a hablar un poquito de esto. You know, like it's just there's more. Like in English, I'm just like, hey, what's up? Sometimes that happens when I perform in Spain and they look at me like they don't understand deadpan very much yet. They don't really get sarcasm as well as we do. So they just kind of look at me like I'm weird. Then I just think, well, I don't have to live in this country. I can just go back to America and I'll be fine.
Give it up for Carmen Lynch.
It's so good to be here. Please laugh at my jokes. I have a heart murmur. So, it's all right. I'm okay with it. I don't think I'm gonna live a long life because I've never seen any really tall old ladies. Thank you for laughing at that. This could be my last show. I'm doing yoga. It's all right. It's all right. They just have these weird names for poses, you know, like the happy baby pose. Yeah, you just lie on your back and you spread your legs all the way. And then you have to put your hands on your feet so your legs remain spread eagle. And then some guy comes in and f*** you. So... Yeah. Breakups are the worst. I'm sure some of you are thinking about it, but you just can't talk about it because that person's here. There's so much conflict and confrontation in a breakup, so much anxiety. Like one time I had to break up with this guy and he was like, "What are you looking for?" And I was like, "The door, I just want to get out of here." Breakups suck because you break up and then you see all kinds of stuff that reminds you of that person and then it's really hard to get over them, you know? Like I dated a black guy for a while and then we broke up and like a week later there were black people everywhere. I was like, I'm never gonna get over this guy. He's all over the place. So I have to wear a mouth guard at night, which is not attractive at all. So if I'm dating someone and he comes over that first time and I'm wearing my mouth guard, I have to come up with a reason why that's like sexy so he doesn't run out the door. So I have to say something like, "Look,